स्टार्ट मैम।
सर आई समथिंग अबाउट न्यू बिगिनिंग्स द स्टार्ट ऑफ न्यू स्कूल ईयर मेकिंग न्यू फ्रेंड्स एक्सप्लोरिंग न्यू प्लेसेस लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स रीडिस्कवरिंग योर सेल्फ अगैन मूविंग फ्रॉम द पास्ट इट्स सच अ रिफ्रेशिंग फीलिंग अ न्यू डे अ न्यू ईयर वेर वी लेट गो ऑफ वॉट वॉज एंड लुक फॉरवर्ड टू ऑल दैट इज टू बी A very good morning. We, the Oakhart family, are here to welcome you all for the new academic year 2021-22. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to today's orientation program. I extend my hearty welcome to our dear principal, Mr. Pradeep Sharma, our coordinators, Ms. Hetal Ahivasi, Mr. Mandar Gurjar, Mr. Nirmalendra Tripathi. A warm welcome to all the parents and our beloved students who are here with us today. Let's begin today's orientation program with our school anthem. I request you all to rise for the school anthem.
Here every day has a dawn of new beginning, nurtured with the best of everything. Let's be this day with open arms, let's fuel our dreams with enlightening sparks. We learn beyond the four walls, we don't have any fear to fall, we walk together, we stand tall. Imagination. We're inspired to create great innovation. With courage in our hearts, we take the lead. Love and humility be our creed. Alma mater, flesh to you. We give our best, we stay true. We focus, we pursue. Win laurels and hearts too.
Great school leaders constantly pay attention. They build a culture focused on students' learning. They confront mediocre teaching. They invite, they inspire. They support families, students, and school staff in a way that leads to improvement. They want to be trusted, not simply liked. Oakhardians are blessed with such a leader. Mr. Pradeep Sharma, the head of the school. Sir, I welcome you to address the gathering.
Thank you, Suja. Hi, audience, those who are here, parents and students, we are actually missing you all. So let me take it up from here. International Baccalaureate Education has recently celebrated its 50th anniversary. A lot of change in last 50 years. If now 7,000 plus, as if now 7,000 plus programs are offered across the globe. The interesting fact is that the IB has maintained its purpose, which is education for a better world. Over these 50 years, IB has ensured to maintain its relevance in the field of education, which has seen its curricular standards, programs, and its philosophy are benchmarked against the best in the world all the times to remain word relevant. IB ensures that the teachers who are running the programs have real input into the way IB develops its programs. That collaboration from across the globe teaching community makes the taught curriculum more relevant and advanced. Assessments are highly textured and spend significant time to understand the learning a child has developed. The world is changing very fast. Parents are more worried about their children. IB believes in better preparation as the world is moving into fourth industrial revolution and kind of thinking needed among the citizenry and among our young people is quite different. The content is changing on a fast basis. Children who enter a bachelor's program, that content is not going to be relevant by the time they graduate. So the IB teaches each individual to think. Think, forget, rethink, recompose is a way of we think of things. Who knew that in our lifetime that the cars would be driving themselves? We are in an era now where machines starting to think for themselves. Teaching and learning in IB is different. It is not I teach, you learn, the end. It's much more than that. IB teaching is a constant web of instructions among teachers, students, and parents. Concepts are at the core of combinations with essential skills and critical thinking. It's a balanced program delivered collaboratively by the IB certified subject experts. And mind it, it's very, very important. Participants, teachers and students and parents also, they experience different in the coming days when you'll be joining our program, those who are new, and they'll understand how the IB program is meant and developed for their kids. We, the Work Hard Global School, welcome you to 2022 program. And I would like to share a little presentation for you people here. If you could just give me a minute, please. Just a second. There you go. Right. So welcome to Work Hard Global School session 2021-22. I would also like to announce that on 14th June 2021, we're going to launch our yearbook 2020-21 towards tomorrow. You can access the PDF version from our school's website. The link is given here and you can access our website around 10 a.m. or after 10 a.m. on Monday to access the yearbook. COVID-19 has forced human race to a new normal. This has also brought challenges with blessings in disguise. It is up to us how to enhance and turn the situation in our favor and make the organization an IB philosophy-based ecosystem for teachers, students, parents, and stakeholders. So our target is to make WGS an exemplary school for the IB community and a school which would suit our requirements and prepare our students for the future. With this motto, I have our team commanders, and the team commanders are Jayant Pade. He's our admin manager, so you will be seeing him for the transport and other fees related other issues. He's always there to help you out. My primary year head, Ms. Hit Ehwasi, she is in charge for the primary program, so she'll definitely speak to you on her program and how it is going to work out. Mr. Mandar Gujar is our head for middle year program. So grade 6 to 10th is all with him under his aegis. And Mr. Nirmalendu Tripathi, he is head of IB diploma program. Popularly in our zone, if you wish to compare, then of course it is junior college program, equivalent program. To help them out to manage the program on ground level, we have leads for each program. We have Mr. Mahesh as DP lead, Ms. Vichitra as MYP lead, Ms. Anjali as EYP lead, Ms. Bhavna, who's a counselor and cluster lead. Miss Suja, as you can see our MC today, she is cluster lead. Our affiliations, I would like to share with my parents what affiliations we have. So we are affiliated to International Baccalaureate Program, and we are now an IB Continuum school. So when I say Continuum, it means it is the only school which would offer all three programs, primary year program, middle year program, and diploma program together in under one roof. So that's one beauty is there. And we are a 37th IB Continuum school in India. The school is also an examination center for college boards, SAT and PSAT. In times to come, we are also going to offer GRE and TOEFL. We are a part of UCAS University Gateway Program. So if students are planning to study in UK, UCAS is another way to get in touch with that. International School Theatre Association is another affiliation what we have with us. So we're looking forward to have some exchange programs under this. And along with that, I would also like to share, if you look at the graph, our growth till 2021, we started with us 2016 with the association of 8 members, 13 students. And as of now, we have around 75 plus associates. We have all three programs, PYP, MYP, and DP. And students are, of course, more than 300. This is the calendar which has been shared with the parent community in past. If you go through your mail, which was shared in the month of March, again in April, and recently as on Friday, the attachment has this calendar, which shows what are the dates when we are open, what are the dates when we are not functioning. And this would help you plan your year ahead. And the school is known for sticking to the dates. We never compromise with our calendar. That's what makes it more feasible and, you know, more approachable for parents to plan the year. So on Wednesday, 18 March 2020, it was announced that thousands of schools in India were closed, and they were asked to close the campus. And the Economist magazine, if I go by their data, over 1 billion students are going to be out of the school. And it is really, really crucial to continue the learning cycle. And we, being a responsible school, are following that. So if I go by that, we are among those fortunate group of members where our students are taken care of. And last year, we really managed on the learning cycles, and we wish to continue the same thing. So we are constantly working on the improvement of what we do and how we deliver our lessons to the students. In times to come, after second wave, we have worked out three scenarios. Scenario one, when everything gets under control and students are allowed to come for face-to-face classes, nothing like it. If scenario two could be hybrid model, where a certain number of students would be allowed to walk into the school and others will be taking virtual classes, or schedule would be made in such a way that for 2 days, students will come to the campus and 3 days, they'll be taking virtual classes and so forth. It all depends on the government notifications and how the GRs are released. If nothing happens, of course, we are all set. We have our plan in place for distance learning, which is 2.0, another level now. We have a lot of apps we have purchased. We have invested heavily on our online teaching methods, which has really helped our teachers to present the program, the teaching in an effective way. I would also like to share that the school timings are going to be a little different from what we've been doing so far. The school reporting time, instead of 8, is now 8:30 a.m. The breakfast will be served at 9:10, and the lunch will be served around 12 noon o'clock. The dispersal would be around 2:45 if we go for physical school. In that case, the school will also offer some optional activities for the students, and they would be departing around 4 o'clock. So a typical day would look like somewhat like that, that you'd have a student will have HRT time when they reach to the school. They'll have a little assembly, and after assembly, they have period 1 to 8, including all mini breaks and lunch break and breakfast. After 2:45, students can choose to go in for any sporting activity or extra classes or whatsoever they are looking for, of course, on little chargeable basis. The school policies are another thing which I would like to highlight here for my parents, parent community. The policies are actually an integral part of our system, and I would request if parents can go through these policies, and they could be part of the school system. So these policies are all available on school's website, and they address our assessment systems, admission systems, academic honesty systems, the inclusion policy and the language policy. And of course, I would also like to mention that we regularly update these policies. And the cycle is set at for the first 5 years, is set for 1 year. Every year we do it. And after 5 years, of course, we'll be revisiting on 2 years or 3 years cycle. Excuse me. The open days, what we have planned this year are definitely the dates would be shared with you. And these are the days when the doors of the school would be open for all. You, along with your family, friends, your relatives, can walk into the school and experience how the teaching is done in the IB school. And definitely, I would want parents to take keen interest in this. Another request is parents volunteer program. In past 2 years, we had a larger number of parents taking interest into the volunteer program. It was a grand success, and this has really helped our students to understand different perspectives, different challenges, what people have faced, and how the success is something which can be achieved with hard work. So we expect our parents to volunteer minimum 5 hours per term. We are expecting you people to be associated with school at least 5 to 10 hours, I mean 10 hours if I say in a year. And of course, you can get in touch with our coordinators for more details, how you can contribute as one of the volunteer for the school program. After my presentation, Ms. Hetal is going to explain how the PYP program is going to look like this year. After Ms. Hetal, we'll have Mr. Mandar speaking on MYP, and followed up by Mr. Nirmalendu Tripathi, would be mentioning the highlights of DP program this year. For any questions, try to get in touch with us. You can always send us a WhatsApp on this number, or you can write an email, and we have 24 hours responding policy. So within 24 hours, you'll get a response from us. That's it from my side, Suja. Over to you.
Thank you, sir. She's a person with a pleasant disposition. She's approachable and marks her presence with her calm and positive attitude. Ms. Hetal Ahivasi, the primary years program coordinator at Okhad Global School. Ms. Hetal, I welcome you to introduce the primary years program.
Thank you so much, Suja. Thank you, Pradeep, sir. A very warm welcome to all the parents, and good morning. Once again, I am really glad to be sharing more details about the primary years program at WGS. And I would also like to share a small presentation with you all. And while I show it, I'll be giving you all a little more detail about each and every slide. So here it goes. All right, so the IB PYP program, the primary years program, is basically designed for the children aged 3 to 12 years, and it nurtures and develops young students as caring and active participants in a lifelong journey. The PYP offers an inquiry-based and a transdisciplinary curriculum framework that builds conceptual understanding amongst the students. As I said, that we do not just focus on ensuring that the children are studying different subjects in the classroom, but we also ensure that these students become global citizens and definitely have more inculcated international mindedness amongst them. For doing the same, there are certain important aspects and elements of the PYP, amongst which the foremost and the most important one, I would say, is the learner profiles. There are 10 learner profiles, which basically build up a student's moral values. So you would definitely remember that while you were in school, we were taught that you have to be honest. You have to be someone who follows rules and regulations, does their own work. So these are same kind of, essential agreements that the students come up along with their teachers. We do not basically force them that they have to become independent or they have to, be inquirers in the classroom, but we try to inculcate them via the classroom healthy atmosphere. Now, what is the difference between the traditional teaching methodology and the PYP classrooms? The foremost lies where the teacher is not in complete control of the classroom. When I say control, I do not mean that she doesn't have classroom management skills. Here I mean is that the teacher is not giving just directions to the students, but she's also ensuring that the students are an equal part of the classroom. They also have their own voice. The planning, the sessions, the work that they do in the classroom is interactive enough. And that is one of the reasons that why PYP does not follow any one set pattern of textbooks. Because we believe that no 20 students of a particular classroom can fall under the same umbrella of one workbook or a textbook. So the teachers definitely plan in varied ways, depending on the style of the learner's learning and their patterns of learning. Students are also at times divided in various groups, or at times given independent learning time or to work on the projects in the classroom. The teachers definitely play a role of the facilitator while all of this is going on in their classes. Now, when I have spoken about that PYP is more to do with inquiry, so this is what I mean, that inquiry is not just where the teacher gives out a question and the students are just finding out that what exactly the question has the answer like. But there is a complete cycle which they follow, and there are various inquiry cycles listed on the IB website as well, and we are free to choose one of them. As a school, we at the moment follow something which is here on my screen, where we tune in, we find out, we sort out further into the concept, we make connections, and the last one is taking action. Action is something which is not again forced by the teachers, but the students are free to take actions on their own. At times, students also showcase these actions after a long gap when the concept was over, but they are showing the action after 6 months, eight months, or at times even after 1 or 2 years of that inquiries when that inquiry was over. Concept-driven curriculum. PYP is a concept-driven curriculum, and it is conceptually organized. We do not focus just on topics. We follow on we believe and follow that concepts build real understanding, and they bring focus and depth to the students' learning. And the students definitely construct more meaning to it. They connect their life, real life examples to whatever they learn in the classroom. So their knowledge and real life experience are very much connected. And this can be seen when they are having some open conversations with their teachers. The teachers definitely maintain a record of the same as well. There are 7 major key concepts that we focus on: the form, the function, causation, change, connection, perspective, and responsibility. These form a major part when the teachers are planning for the sessions. There are 6 TD themes, the transdisciplinary themes that the PYP focuses on. These are globally accepted themes: who we are, where we are in place and time, how we express ourselves, how the world works, how we organize ourselves, and sharing the planet. The kindergarten section, that is EYP, nursery to KG2, are free to choose anywhere between 4 to 6 themes throughout the year. But the PYP, that is grade 1 to 5, definitely focuses on completing all the 6 TD themes in the span of 12 months. We also focus on inculcating and building up the skills: the thinking skills, social skills, communication skills, self-management skills, and the research skills. these are again ensured that every moment that the student is in the classroom, maybe communicating to the teachers or to the peers or working independently or in a group, these skills are taken care of. These are again later broken down into several set of sub-skills. We don't just have approaches to learning, but we also have approaches to teaching. These are certain set of, I would say again, agreements for the teachers that we keep in mind when we are planning for the lessons, be it any subject, whether it is math, English, music, dance, physical education. These are some of the things that the teachers keep in mind. We ensure that there is enough scope for the student to explore the local and the global context, that they can definitely work out in teams and collaborate, not just in the classroom, but also at times beyond the classroom. We definitely have several times students connecting to the schools globally and connecting on a similar topic which they are doing in the classroom. Choose, act, and reflect. When we talk about the action cycle, this is where the students are basically taken along with the teachers. We do not force them. I would again emphasize on it. The students definitely have some self-realizations. They reflect, and that's how they take actions. And definitely they do feel very, very proud of it. There have been certain enhancements in the PYP in the past 2 years' time. There is more importance given and emphasis given on a student agency. That is where we'll have to honor more the student choice, voice, and their ownership. And this is definitely coming up as a very beautiful concept in every PYP schools, because the student at different age groups are contributing along with the teachers while they are planning for their units, making the planners, or they are planning the assessments or the reporting system. And this is one of the wonderful ways of recording the student learning as well. The last but not the least is the assessment part. The assessment is not just for the students or to judge the student, I would say. This is basically for the teachers and the students both. When the teachers plan for the assessment, they definitely keep in mind that whatever they have explored with the students in the class, how far has the student understood it? How far the student finds it good enough to showcase their understanding. There are different ways of assessing the students, and every different learners at times can be assessed in a different variety of ways. Sometimes the student present a work, sometimes a student may write down the work, sometimes a student may just orally tell us what is their understanding of a concept. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope that all your doubts are cleared in this. I'm always available, just an email away or a phone call away at school. And if you have any further doubts, I'll be more than happy to solve them out. Over to you, Suja. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hetal. With us, we have Mr. Mandar, our middle year programs coordinator. He's a person with simple outlook. He's an expert in his field and has continued to inspire immensely to the Oakhart teaching community. So I welcome you to introduce the middle years program.
Thank you, Pradeep sir. Thank you, Hetal, and thank you, Suja. Dear parents, as we are beginning our academic year 21-22, I welcome you all for this MYP orientation session. Though most of you are aware about MYP model, please still refer to this model as our entire MYP revolves around this model. Let me share my screen. As our entire MYP programs revolve around this model, as I mentioned before, you can see 8 subject groups in this model. You have language and literature, you have language acquisition, You have individuals and societies, you have mathematics, you have design, you have arts, you have sciences, and you have physical and health education. So MYP deals with all these 8 subject groups. Apart from this, you can see in this model, inside action and service component, as well as you can see community project and personal project. Topmost inside the model, you can see approaches to learning, global context, and approaches to teaching. And at the center, you will see a learner. So it clears that it is student-led program. The core elements are personal project, services action, and interdisciplinary learning in MYP. As you come out, you will learn the subjects, but the essence will remain with interdisciplinary approach, with developing the skills, with action and service orientation. So parents, this is the model we are following in WGS and across the globe. Now, let me quickly brief you about our achievements so far, since we have got the authorization for our program. Since our authorization in January 2020 for the IB-MYP, our student strength in MYP is continuously growing. This year, it is touching 50. Our MYP 5 batch, that is grade 10 board batch, you can say, appeared for the personal project moderation and an on-screen examination conducted by the IB in this year, in May 21, despite the challenges we faced due to COVID. Thanks to our team of dedicated teachers, our IT department, and our exam department. In fact, I'm proud to say that only IB conducted on-screen examination for grade 10 students across the globe with thorough professionalism despite pandemic situation. No other boards, including international board, conducted grade 10 exams this year due to pandemic situation where the IB has conducted and our students appear for it. Our MYP students successfully completed and exhibited their personal project virtually appreciated across the globe. So this is our achievements so far. Now, I want to share with you how our MYP program is going to look like in academic year 21-22. As you are aware, online or virtual classes will happen in Microsoft Teams till we get clear guidelines from the government for conducting physical classes. Our assignments, tasks, worksheets, assessment, etc. will be shared through ManageBack with you. Curriculum for the first unit will be shared through ManageBack and subsequently for other units from time to time. Resources in terms of books, website, blogs, etc. will be shared with you from time to time. We will have a balanced approach for the use of technology along with notebooks, especially from MYP 1 to MYP 3. MYP 4 and 5, we will have laptops allowed for their learning. Then what is there apart from all this? We are having a Marathi language at beginner's level in MYP 1 as per the state government norms and subsequently IB's decision. There will be 3 languages in MYP 1. English as a language and literature, or a student can choose Hindi as also a language and literature. Hindi or French as language acquisition, and Marathi, which will be non-assessed, is the third language. For MYP 3 to MYP 5, there will be 2 languages, English and Hindi or French, as already selected by the students. For the selection in MYP 1, students need to select either English or Hindi as language and literature, Hindi or French as language acquisition, after exploring or attending both the classes for a few days. For these few days, MYP 1 students will explore both the languages while attending both Hindi and French before choosing the second language. MYP 5 students will be registered for on-screen e-assessment board examination to be conducted by IB in May 22. There will be two term assessments at the end of term 1 and term 2 apart from regular formatives and summatives. There will be few more orientation sessions for the parents as per the need. Interaction with few schools that includes students and teachers from India and abroad to explore different cultures and systems if possible. And field trips definitely will be there once the routine gets normal, or we are allowed to come physically to the campus. I think this brief orientation, over to the DP coordinator, Mr. Nirmal Endu. But before that, if you have any more in-depth discussion for MYP, you can always get in touch with our homeroom teacher, or you can mail us so that we can plan further sessions with the parents. Thank you, all of you. Thank you, Suja.
Thank you, sir. Fun-loving, outgoing, a great artist, knowledgeable, yet ever ready to learn. A great guide who inspires everyone around him to achieve their best potential. He is Mr. Nirmalendu Tripathi, our diploma program coordinator. Sir, I welcome you to introduce the diploma program.
Thank you, Suja, for this humble introduction. Good morning, all dear parents and students. I welcome you all for the new academic year 21-22. And I'll just quickly brief you about the post 10th grade education, the higher secondary education known as IB Diploma program, and the subject groups that are available and how the student has to opt for the subjects. The diploma school also is assisted by a counseling office, by a full-time counselor, the university counselor, and students will be guided with pathways for their undergraduate program as well. So I'll just quickly share the screen. Right, we start with the subject groups. So in IB Diploma, there are total 6 subject groups. And in order to do complete the diploma program in 2 years, a student need to select one subject from each subject groups that's mentioned over here. So the subject combinations usually goes this way: 2 languages and 1 mathematics. Apart from these 3 subjects, the student need to select one subject from the remaining 3 groups. However, group 6 is not mandatory. So a student can opt 2 subjects from group 4 or can opt for 2 subjects from group 3. In certain situations, a student who is aiming to sit for engineering entrance examinations in India, otherwise a student aiming to sit for NEET examinations in India for medical sciences, opts for 3 group 4 subjects, that is physics, chemistry and biology, so that the student meets the basic eligibility criteria for sitting for these examinations. So as I said, there are total six subject groups. So a student coming from any board, from state board or national board, even from Cambridge, O-level, so is eligible to opt for the IB diploma program and has to take six subjects from the six subject groups. Now, out of the six subject groups that the student selects, three subjects have to be from higher level and three subjects have to be from standard level. Now, the higher level subjects, a student need to have 240 contact hours with the teacher. And for the standard level, a student need to have 150 contact hours during the 2 years time with the teacher. So coming to the subject combinations and the selection of subjects, so 3 HL and 3 SL are mandatory. Now I go to the core of IB diploma. One second. Yes. So when it comes to the core of IB diploma, again, this is mandatory for every student. In order to earn the IB diploma, a student need to do all the three core that I mentioned out here. So the three cores are like theory of knowledge, that is about a critical thinking course where the student develops the skill of questioning knowledge and writes a 1600 words essay and puts up an exhibition, TOK exhibition. And the next is extended essay, where the student writes a 4000 word research essay, which is outside the classroom teaching. And the third one is about promoting the spirit of service, where they have to do a stipulated number of hours about creativity, activity, and service, keeping the community in mind. So these three core components are mandatory, and a student need to complete them in order to earn the diploma. So apart from the six subjects, these three core components are also to be done before a student completes the IB diploma within 2 years time. Now, the next is about the grading system. Now, as I told, like, there are total six subjects a student need to select out of that. Now, each subject has the highest grade as a seven points. And so total like six subjects, the highest grade, if we put them, goes to total 42 points. And the core elements, TOK and extended essay, has got 1.5 points each. So total it goes to 3 points, and 42 plus 3 total goes to 45 points. CAS doesn't have any point system, but is mandatory. A student need to complete all the CAS hours, the planning, then execution, implementation, and reflection. So total points goes to 45. Next is about yes, there is a provision for a student, as I told, like, out of the six subjects that the student need to select, two of them are languages, which is compulsory. So one from group one and the other from group two. However, a student can select two languages from group one. So in that case, the student is given the status of bilingual diploma. So the IB awards the degree to a student bilingual diploma, or considers as bilingual diploma, when a student has taken two subjects, two languages from group one. So language and literature, known as language and literature. Like a student from India taking Hindi and English, both in group one, or even it's quite a fashion, student take French and English in group one, then the student earns the status of bilingual diploma. So in that case, the student need not to choose any language from group two, that is language acquisition. However, the mathematics from group five, and then the remaining three subjects are to be selected apart from the two languages that the student takes from group one. Now, there are a few important points here. A student need to have at least 24 points in order to get the IB diploma, in order to be awarded with the IB diploma. So in all the HL subjects, so out of three HL subjects that the student chooses, so in each of them, the student need to score 4 points each out of seven. And in each of the SL subjects, the student need to score at least 3 points in each one of them. So total it goes to 4 threes are 12 points for HL, and 3 threes are 9, that is 9 points. So 12 plus 9 goes to 21 points, and from core, that is TOK, 1.5 points, and then extended essay 1.5 points. So total goes to 24. So in order to earn the IB diploma, the student need to score a minimum of 24 points. As I mentioned, the highest is 45 points, and out of the student population who appear for the IB diploma program across the globe, near about 100,000 in Indian context, near to 1 lakh students appear for the IB diploma program across the globe. Out of that, near to 5,000 students get 45 out of 45 points. So that indicates the it's near about 5%. So it indicates the academic rigor and challenge of the IB diploma program. Now, a student who earns the IB diploma is welcomed by the best universities across the globe because of the academic rigor that they undergo, the quality of curriculum that IB diploma offers. Apart from abroad, in India as well, all the universities, if we go to the Association of Indian Universities website, if we see the Ministry of Education website, if we see the University Grants Commission, the UGC website, it's being clearly stated that a IB diploma student pass out is eligible and is allowed to do the undergraduate program in India as well. So it involves both professional as well as liberal arts and other business and design other courses. So the diploma student has got a scope in India as well as abroad, and it's definitely one of the creditable program for a student to join for the undergraduate courses across the globe. So this is all about the IB diploma program. We have a team of near to 17 faculty members who are expert in their field, who are also certified by the IB recognized workshops, and near to five faculty members are IB examiners who actually examine the papers of diploma students from across the globe, standing from Canada to Latin America to Africa to Asia to Europe. So they bring their expertise, they bring their experience, and any IB school, as head of school was mentioning, has got active collaboration and all these faculty members, they actually bring the IB culture alive in the campus of the diploma corridor. We do presently have the diploma 2 students, and the diploma 1 students are very soon going to start their academic year with their all subject combinations and their aims and career goals in place. Thank you all. Any doubt, any queries that comes up, I'm always a phone call away, and you are most welcome to walk in to the school campus once things become normal, and most welcome to visit us and witness our diploma program. Thank you all. Over to you, Suja.
Thank you, sir. Parents, kindly note, grade level orientations will be held on Monday, 14th June. The schedule and the link will be shared with you all soon. The end of every chapter is the beginning of something new. Keep reading. A lot is yet to come. With this, we come to an end of today's orientation program. I request you all to stand up for the national anthem.
Janaganamana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Utchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Thank you.